This week on the Hoover Boys.
Oh, cheers. Oh, baby.
Looking for your pinpointer?
Finally. You fixed me, Doctor. Finally. I'm fixed. I'm back in the Indian zone.
August 23rd, 2015. If you've been keeping up with the videos, you know my luck has changed. I had no luck lately. Can't find anything. Finally think I find a good location. Somebody's already been there, cleaned it out. It's been straining on me. So today, I was looking for a release. So I came here, and despite what the sign says, they didn't have what I was looking for. So I think it's time to bite the bullet. My mind hasn't been right. My body hasn't been right. I gotta go see a doctor. Let's go to the doctor.
The Stealth Doctor.
Nice to meet you, buddy. It's a pleasure.
Yeah,
absolute
man.
Absolute honor.
I'm glad you came in.
Been having problems. You think you can fix me?
Sure. Let's get you back there and give you a little crack-a-lack and see what's going on.
Awesome.
All right. Long ride, huh? Nice. All right.
Oh. So my body feels great. Do you have anything for my mind?
Oh yeah. Mind FX. And this will fix you right up.
Awesome. Got any spots to go digging around here?
Oh, hell yeah.
Let's get on something old.
Let's go.
Well, as you can see, I'm out here with Carol, Just Bob, Brad, and the doctor. Brought us to a permission. Back here in the woods, a whole bunch of foundations to a World War II women's barracks. Train tracks over here. We're going to go investigate that. We've already hit the barracks. Check it out. Hey, Doc, you got anything? I got a 50 caliber shell casing.
Does it look anything like this 50 caliber shell casing?
Yeah, I'd say it looks just like that.
Nice.
World War II, baby.
Woohoo!
Cool. Cheers. Check this out. Right on the surface. Another 50 cal. Thing is massive. Oh, that's the year. That'd be 1943. Bang, bang. I'm gonna do a check-in with Brad, See what he's found. Got anything yet, buddy?
Yeah, what's up, guys? Yeah.
Oh, you found some 50 cals too?
Yeah, I've got some stuff. Each one is supposed to be a cache of coins, but no such luck.
Oh, boom! Dropped one. It's one across. Now I gotta test that thing's durability.
I'm always the guinea pig.
Little guy made it. Getting a 51, 52, 53 signal here. Fairly deep. Thought it was gonna be a shotgun shell. It's not. Little relic. All the way down in there. Pulled out the butt of a spoon handle. Might have a little age to it. Got a little design on there. Cool. It's not a 50 caliber shell. Very nice. Don't get me wrong, they're really cool relics. I mean, World War II. I mean, the first one and two were pretty exciting because I've never found one before. But it's getting pretty ridiculous now. Went up under this tree to get this one. And I hear Brad cleaning out another one too. At least they're not shotgun shells. I have a bunch of them too. Another 50 cal. Bang. There's hope after all. It's getting a 70 signal. It came out of the size of a nickel. I'm like, it's not a nickel because it was ringing at 70. Got a post. It's an old flat button. Probably 1800s. That's a good sign. Relic. Very nice. I got a flat button. Nobody cares. I'll let you listen to one of these 50 caliber shell casings in the ground. They sound amazing when they're like 9 inches deep. Oh, baby. She was down there. Some of them been right on the surface, some of them been 10, 12 inches deep. They always sound good though. Gotta dig it. Dig it all.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, it's recording. So if anybody doesn't know, that's what a deer tick looks like. And they are very small. And we're covered. Awesome. You got another one too, Brad?
Yeah.
Oop. What's it taste like? Lime.
Seriously, if you wouldn't mind, just tell me what's on me.
Why you got that cleaning can on the back then?
Clear?
In the back, don't look too bad.
You want to check down there?
But
while those guys are pulling ticks off of them, I'm going to eat my lunch. I think you should do the same. Eat your lunch.
Looking for your pinpointer?
Had a little lunch. Now we're going to go up the train track, see what's up that way. So the train tracks are literally right there behind me. And I find out which direction they were shooting those 50 caliber bullets. Because I just found the business end of one. Wow. That's massive. Thought Civil War bullets were big. 50 cal. Whoa. Well, I found like 8 more 50 cals. Correction, maybe like 12 more 50 cals. Let's go check on with Bobby.
One weedy.
You got a weedy?
And one silver pin.
Silver?
Nothing about that.
Hey.
Scoreboard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. Thought it was
shiny
I
stuff.
It was junk my first dug it.
They're shiny here. Very good.
Nice. Well, some better than none.
Who found something else? Let me ask, find a coinage?
John just found a buffalo.
A buffalo nickel. Well then.
It is a buffalo. That's the Indian side. Here's the buffalo side. The back looks better than the front. That we're going to get a date.
Very good.
Good dig, gives us hope.
Well, the funny part was, I was using wide open on this, and then I switched just to relics, which I never used the relic.
Yeah.
And the minute I did that, I hit a different signal. It was really weird.
Dumb luck.
Yeah, right?
We're done digging 50 caliber shells, so we're done for the day.
Yeah.
Here's Brad's little pile.
Probably 15, 18 of them.
Yeah. You got a little bale seal. It's kind of toasty. 1950s tag.
Part of the day.
New Jersey. Little bottle. Very nice. It's Carol. She killed a bird.
Damn it, Carol.
Broken pottery and glass. 50 cal.
Forehand.
Bunch of
you got an oil lamp.
Yeah.
Yummy iron.
Yeah, this is a
Earl lamp part. Very nice.
Doll head, like a porcelain disc doll.
It was.
Yeah, it was at some point.
I got a 25 even 50 cal. Got the business end of one. One flatty, spoon handle, clads. I got screwed. Shell casings, junk. This you just, Beb?
Just me.
Just, this is just Bob's just finds.
Just
myself. Got a Ford hubcap and a valve stem cover. 50 cals, of course. This is a weedy?
Yeah.
Wow. It's a little silver pin. That's awesome. Got a little shiny. The doctor scored himself the Buffalo. We got a date. It's 1930. Few shell casings, and he got a couple clips for him. Very cool. Old hook, rusty stuff. That's the way the day went. We had a good time. We dug it all. See you on the next one. You going to check, make sure you got it all?
It's all there, kid.
It's all there?
Yeah.
Today, John brought us to one of his old permissions. Obviously, all farm fields. Beautiful. Nice little breeze today. Used to be an old 1700s church, somewhere right here. A couple old homes before that back here. Let's see what we can find. One of the awesome things, totally awesome things about this area and hunting these fields, lots of Indian artifacts. And Stealth Doctor has a hell of a collection. He found something he wants to show. What you got, buddy?
Well, I got this for you because it popped right up and...
Oh, wow.
There's your axe.
That was definitely worked. Look at that.
It's all smooth and honed on the sides.
Yep. That is awesome.
Now you got some really nice ones to add to your collection to start.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Appreciate it. Yeah, the first day we went to one of the fields and I found a couple hand tools for like smashing nuts or something. Show them to you right now. Couple hand tools. You can't see it, but if you put it perfectly in your hand, your fingers line up from grooves right there and see where they're banging on nuts or something. And this one here is the same way. If it's perfect in your hand, if it's rubbed smooth there where they're rubbing something off. Very cool. Today, here's the one that John threw at me. You see where that one's been rubbed. This might have been for skinning an animal or something. Nice sharp edge to get that skin off the meat.
You found this, Bob?
I did, yeah.
That's my very first Indian artifact.
You can see the grooves in this one. It just fits perfect in your hand. That is insane. It's rubbed all over.
It fits perfect in your hand.
It felt good.
Yeah.
But now that I look at it, I'm like, you're right. It's one finger grease. That's
really cool. It's really cool. It's like, I don't know if I'm metal detecting and searching for artifacts in my eyes or if I'm searching for artifacts in my eyes and metal detecting.
Well, which have you found more of?
There you go.
Here's all the yummy metal signals we've been digging. Nothing great so far. You scored a weedy though, right?
Yeah, want to see it?
Sure.
Yeah, absolutely, weedy excitement, brother.
And that is a 1914. That would have been sweet if it was a D. But, nice oldie.
Very good, sir.
Thanks, buddy.
Carol's going after something. We're going to watch. What you got there?
Like a edge of a earth.
Space junk?
Space junk?
I don't know.
Yeah.
It's yours now.
Thank you.
Yeah, this field's turning into more Indian artifacts than metal detecting finds. Check this one out. I just picked it up. It is worn completely thin here. Look, there's like holes in it. Maybe they're like trying to crack nuts open on it or something. I don't know. It's worn all the way around though. That's a really cool piece. I like that one. Here's another really cool worked rock. Completely flat on this side and that side. So it's like rubbed almost to like a perfect square point. That's really cool. The doc's saying coin. Let's see what he's got.
What you got, buddy?
Well, we got a clump. I broke the clump. And there's the back of the clump. And there's the front of the clump.
Huh.
But I don't know. I didn't clean it. So maybe a penny. I see some.
Yeah, it looked like they got maybe a whack with a plow or something.
Yeah, so we don't know until we take the front off.
We're going to do a little work on it. We'll show you what we got. The doc found a chewed up zinkin. Good job, buddy.
Yeah, man.
Carol just came over and said, Kurt, we're leaving. And I said, hold on, let me dig this signal. Finally, I got a coin. And it's an old coin. Finally, I got an IHP. It's been forever. I've missed you.
You fixed me, doctor. Finally,
I'm fixed. I'm back in the Indian zone.
Redemption.
Yes. Let me clean it up a bit, show you what kind of date we have. That's beautiful. I almost forgot what they looked like. There's the back. Beautiful. 1907. That was a good year. It's not shiny bingo, but that's bingo. So we're changing locations now. This field yielded trash, Indian artifacts, one Indian head penny, and weed. Artifacts. That's really awesome.
Wait, don't forget.
Oh yeah, and the zinkin. Can't forget about the zinkin.
Two-thirds.
And all that yummy trash. Here, clean this mess up and hit the road.
Well, we're going back to the farm fields. So today we're eating our lunch on the road. Eating on the run. Eat your lunch.
Mobile.
Who's driving this thing? I'm not.
Trying to eat.
Eat it.
You're not eating my lunch, are you?
I was just looking at the cardboard, man.
Here's our location now. Kids are already out playing in the field. I'll join them. Doctor just said, got one. What has he got? I don't know. Let's go check it out. You got one, huh?
Good signal.
A tag?
Yeah.
Cool. Anything more?
I didn't clean it yet. We'll have to take a look.
Alrighty.
I was leaving it for you to see.
Can I take a peeky?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, it's got something on there. Vineland. 1947?
Is it? I hit it with the brush?
You can.
All right, let's see what we got.
I've ruined it enough for you. There you have it. Nice little tag. Doctor just said, it's always nice when there's dates on it, because it's easy to date it. What date would you guess it would be?
1947?
You got it.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. You scored a little relic. Part of a harmonica reed. Very nice. There's something peeking out of the edge of a clump.
What it is? Wire? What is that? Pull tab?
Something fancy. Yeah, I think it's a pull. Turn it around the other way.
Oh, yep.
Pull tab.
There you go.
It was scary for a second.
I have a silver dime reading over there. Listen to this signal. That's coming out of the ground.
It was junk. Carol's over here rubbing on something. Let's go check it out.
What do we got there?
I have no idea, but look how deep it was.
It is down there.
Yeah.
Just a tack of some sort.
Down there like that.
Screw. Sort of plate to something.
Yep.
Fancy junk. Carol's screaming at us again, so let's go see what's going on. Screaming at me.
I'm a screamer.
Uh-oh.
There's a little buckle here. I don't think it's worth tack to you.
Could be. Who knows?
I don't know.
It's a little one. Very nice. Nice to see something besides canned slaw.
Yes.
Good dig.
I know. I'm excited.
Yeah. A little debuckle. That thing was screaming at me. Screaming at me. So I'm thinking silver quarter. Nope. Debuckle. I see you over there, Carol. Digging them holes. Digging them holes. Let's go see what you found. Oh, it's out of the hole.
Yep. Was out of the hole.
More junk?
I think it's junk.
Yeah. I found the other part of that junk earlier today.
I'm sure you did.
They rang up awesome. Ugh. Hard working. Rabble, rabble, rabble.
We're done. We're hungry, we're thirsty, we're tired. Check out all these awesome things we found.
Look at all that trash. Yummy. I think this is Carol's pile. Shotgun shells, couple little buckles. It's John's tag, the doctor's tag. Doctor tag. Shotgun shells, little pieces of lead. I found something like this. Right here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Controller.
Yeah. I got a nickel, a little debuckle. A couple debuckles over there.
We dug it all and we had fun. See ya. At least it wasn't hot today.
Be baffled.
I went to the truck to get my sunglasses. The doctor goes, got a coin. Let's see what's going on.
Let me get it down in here. Oh yeah. Oh, it's got some size to it. Nickel size maybe?
Oh, it is a nickel.
Just a, come here for a Jefferson nickel.
Okay. Well, next one I'll make sure it's something good before I call you. I got excited.
I swear it's the first time it's ever happened. Shot his load. Well, the doc just chucked a horseshoe at me.
Ask him the weather in China.
Freaking hot.
Just wanted to get a shot of our trash bucket from the last couple days. Pretty impressive.
The 5-gallon bucket, it's like half full. A lot of canned slaw.
We helped clean up the ground, buddy. You did a good job.
Yummy.
Yummy. Yummy trash.
We had to move some dirt for that.
Yeah.
The Hoover boys are serious when it comes to the rules and laws of digging. We value the historical significance of our finds, and wish to preserve the hobby for future generations. We are not serious when it comes to ourselves. We like to have fun and enjoy the friendships we've made out detecting. Thank you for watching and supporting what we do. Cheers!